Hello everyone. It's shortly after 5 o'clock, so I guess we should get started. Our session right now is Bridging the Gender Gap. We have 3 presentations, each one is 20 minutes. The first presenter is Marios Magalhaetis. He will be presenting working with feminist groups, and he's representing the Wikimedia community user group Greece.
Yeah. Okay, hi. It's working. So what I'm going to do is to present you the work we did on gender gap the last year in Greece, where I ran a series of workshops and talks and meetings with the help of a WMF grant. And these are the partial results of the things we have done so far. So let's discuss about gender gap in Greece. In Greece we have the common problem that everybody has, with very few articles about concerning women issues, but at the same time we had a very strong feminist movement fighting for different aspects of things that affect women or are of women interest, like reproductive rights, sexuality, prostitution. And so the idea that we had is that to approach groups that have done work on that, so they have published texts, they have made an analysis on these things, and work with them in a strong collaboration. If you see in the matter of when it comes in matter of articles in biographies, the problem is that 87.5% of the articles in Greek Wikipedia, it's about males, and only 12% it's about females. This was the situation before we start, anyway. But this is the numbers you expect in almost. Okay, you expect. I mean, this is the numbers you will see probably in most of the Wikipedias anyway. So, if you see, for example, in the feminist by country, in Commons, there's no category for feminism in Greece. Even if we had a lot of documents, we had a lot of actions, there are many protests about different things. Like in 2004, we had a law about prostitution in Greece, where the government allowed prostitution to be held in many places, and things changed on that direction. We have no fingerprints of this strangle of the feminist movement against prostitution and prostitution laws in Wikipedia. The same happens in laws about abortion and many other laws that the feminist movement in Greece have fought in the past. No, not only the 70s, I mean in completely modern history, in the last 10 and 15 years, we have no documents of that fight in the Greek Wikipedia. Of course, we have the same problem in participation. After we asked people to define their gender in Greek Wikipedia, 80% of the people who decided to define their gender via the preferences option, 80% of them were male, and only 20% were female. The same in our user group, there were no active female users. We had some females in the past in the user group, but they gradually became inactive. Of course, this affects the content of the Wikipedia in order to and gives a completely male point of view in many aspects, and also affects the way we work in many places. So what we did is that we contacted 3 groups in Greece. One is C-Sharp, which is a group of female-oriented but mixed group. Both males and females work in C-Sharp, of volunteers that focuses on enhancing the approach of women in technology. And they are mainly oriented in Thessaloniki. And with them, we already have done 2 hackathons in the past. The second one was Telesila, which is a magazine in Greece that is completely dedicated to feminist actions. And they exist since the 1980s. and they have a very large archive in Greece. They have a sort of library, and they also keep a record of all the newspapers on female subjects and things about feminism in Greece. They had a lot of action during the Olympic Games and other places. And we also approached Tomov, which means the purple in Greek. It's also a feminist group. And we asked them to discuss the problem in various directions. The discussion was focused in things like, should they edit in Wikipedia? Is Wikipedia a friendly space for females to participate? Should they, for example, come to us and invest time to pass a part of their archives and documents in Wikipedia Commons? Because there was a lot of information in them, things that they are not even online, and we had to work with them in order to convince them. Okay, I'm not talking about C Sharp. C Sharp is IT, so they had everything online, and they are not focusing on feminism. The other two groups are completely feminist, all feminist groups. And the idea is that we focus time in meetings in order to convince them that they have to pass this information in Wikipedia, because we thought this is going to be important from creating a neutral point of view. In the discussions, we had a lot of criticism about Wikipedia being prevailed by males, and that even the feminist movement is wrongly promoted via Wikipedia, and there were many discussions about what to do if they really have to invest time from their actions also to move in Wikipedia. What we did is that we organized workshops with females all over Greece in the last 12 months in three or four in four different cities. We invited women to come and add content in Wikipedia. We created a bot to create articles that were in Wikidata or in other Wikipedias, and we started working with women already familiar with computers and technology. We started making meetings like at least 2 hours per month in Greece. We gave talks to convince them participate with us, and we made a lot of discussion about how, for example, to pass photos from their hives from different demonstrations in Greece on female subjects on Wikipedia and the benefits of that. And we even created a page for that. We made the page gendergap.wikimedia.gr, where we allowed everyone people could come and arrange a meeting with me, and then I could go to their city and make a round table, discuss the situation, because Telesila, for example, has a magazine, has more than 1,000 subscribers all over Greece, and they are located in many places. So if subscribers of the magazine want a meeting with me, they could arrange it via the page and tell me that, like, in 1 month we would like you to come in our city and discuss about Wikipedia. That's what we did. Of course, most of the content, unfortunately, it's in Greek, because I started by writing everything in English, but then I got complaints that this also was a part of making Wikipedia hostile for not having content in local language. And one of the things we did is that we distributed a questionnaire via the magazine and online. So the magazine helped us to distribute a questionnaire to all the subscribers of the magazine to ask about female things, because from the discussions we concluded that the main idea behind this is that, first of all, to understand why women don't edit Wikipedia, and focus on this direction. These are the results from less than 100 people who replied, because these are the partial results. I still haven't collected the offline questionnaires. This is only the online ones. First of all, okay, we asked about age. You expect that most of the people were in the range of 31 to 40. Okay, these are Google generated. I have made some mistakes because I was changing the data every time, because there were more and younger people, and I had to change this 2-3 times. So you have to combine to see the results. And one of the, we started recording the marital status and the children, because one of the reasons they gave us for not editing Wikipedia or not is because they usually do additional jobs at home, and they are usually more occupied than men. And this is one of the reasons women don't have so much time to do with technology. And so we started recording how many people, how many children they have, etc., etc., to see the profile. We also asked the, probably we expect that this is going to change, because these are only the online results. So these women that have replied in so far here are only the women that already have internet access and already can fill out the Google Forms we created. But our research also extends to women that don't have any internet access. We want to understand why this happens, for example.
You have 5 minutes left.
Okay, I have 7 minutes. So this is the education, the occupation, and then we asked some questions like if they think that the internet exists already. And what is really surprising for me is that from the people who replied, only 22% of the women that replied said that they were a victim of sexism online. And I expect that with the offline results, this is going to be, I don't know. This is very interesting. I believe that this is also because some women are victims of sexism online, and they don't understand they are victims of sexism online, and so probably we have to research more on that. This is another question about in things that of the articles that they believe that they are male oriented and male. That males prevail on them, on how the things are written. And, you know, because there's big discussion of how the articles are presented on Wikipedia, if they focus more on different subjects of the people. Then we asked about if they believe Wikipedia is reliable, because this is also a question. We have to convince the groups that the Wikipedia is reliable. It's a reason for them to come and help. If they believe it's a completely hostile environment, they won't come and edit. And also, if they consult Wikipedia. Okay, there's another question about how much they believe it's about men or males. And this is another question we expected the answer to that, because the thing is that we expected that women don't want to write only about women or about female subjects. In all the editions we organized in Greece, women were writing about everything. We had women writing about spaceships, women writing about football. So the stereotype that says that there are male and female subjects doesn't really work out here. And so most of the women don't want to write about articles about women, I mean exclusively, that's the main idea.
Marius Rene is yes?
Sorry.
Yeah.
I didn't translate that, yeah.
Yes,
okay. Nay is yes, it's a surprise in the Greek language. Yeah, I didn't translate, yeah. Oh.
Yeah.
This happens very often in the... Nobody told me. Oops. Yeah, that's a good question. Yeah. The blue is yes. Okay. She's pressing me to go faster. Anyway. So, results. After 12 months of editing, we improved from 88 to 11 to 76 to 23, but it was motivating more people to more women to write on Wikipedia. This is the number of males and females. Yeah. Upline males. I just translate everything, sorry. Yeah. So things are getting better, that's the main idea of this.
How come it grew to 93%?
Yeah?
How come it grew to 93%?
From? Ah, because we have also numbers of...
It's always 100%.
It has to be always 100%. The last one is 71.95 and 28.05.
I understand that, but was it the number of new articles or...?
No, this is the people of gender who had defined gender on Wikipedia. Editors. This is the number of editors.
That's what I thought, but I wasn't sure. Like, was it the 93% of all editors were male?
No, this is per year, how many, from the people who have defined the gender, how are males and how many are females. Because what happened here is, okay, the editions, in fact, almost failed. If we talk about content, how much content we did in these workshops, we say we failed. There were very few articles. In one workshop, there was only one article created. We spent 5 hours there, and all the women just were in front of one laptop, and they just created one article. So from the point of adding content, we failed, but I have some explanation for that. So, in the positive things is that one active female we had in the group, and she was in one of the first CE meetings some years ago. She got reactivated, but she's the mother of two, and she now helps like organizing the events, but not really editing. We have two female Wikipedia editors where we met in Thessaloniki, and they expressed interest to join the user group. I need extension, time extension. We had a lot of female editors that they did 10 edits during the tutorials. But the most important thing for us is that we gained trust in this thing now. So focusing just adding content fails. And I have a citation from yesterday. Thanks to Vasya who put that on Facebook. Your edit count is not your contribution. I hope Catherine really said that because I was not there. But I trust Vasya that she really said that.
It's not your only contribution.
Yeah. It's not your only contribution.
It's
yeah.
Out of the
yeah, exactly. That's what we really discovered, that there were so many women really wanting to help us now in organizing hackathons, in doing other stuff, really doing things for the user group, but not just adding content on Wikipedia and editing Wikipedia. What we focus on is what my dream, let's say, for that is that I take these archives. They have huge books and they have a lot of newspapers, collected magazines, etc., etc. I want to collect this and start scanning everything on Commons. That will be my dream. From there,
she's gonna
yeah.
Do stuff.
Okay. Okay.
How about the copyrights of this?
I have. Ah, here. So, this is the result. In 2 weeks, we organize a WikiFem hack in Thessaloniki, which is a combined hackathon, edithon, gender gap, everything. We do everything and we are the best thing. This is the venue is given to us by the municipality of Thessaloniki. It's a very nice place. We will have talks about Wiki loves women, Wiki women camp, etc., etc. You are invited to come. Everything will be bilingual. Okay. Thanks.
Thank you.
So, questions or?
Are there any questions for Marius?
I was going to be loud enough. So, I kind of thought, what about these articles? You said that there weren't any. Were they systematically deleted or what happened? Like, no one wanted to write about women in.
No, I mean, there were articles, but in most of the meetings I did, the women I contacted, they had no experience of writing articles before, so they were more keen on asking questions about what is Wikipedia, basic stuff, instead of just say, okay, give me something to write about. there were discussions of what could be the content. They say, okay, can we write about our organization? Can we write about this demonstration? Can we write about the developments in Poland, about abortion, etc., abortion law? Can we write about the laws in Greece about these things?
But no one is against those subjects.
No, yeah.
No one wanted to write.
No, I mean, during the edithons, we had like four or five hours there. The time was limited and it was more about questions, yeah.
And I just quickly wanted to add, that's actually something that happens in many different like language Wikipedias, that when you have women editathons, the focus is not as much on creating content as it is for other editathon groups. It's a lot more about the socializing and the atmosphere, and that's been observed in various communities. I think that's just less content during the editathon.
You might be interested to check what they do in Austria with the Wiki Loves Peace, which this year was dedicated to gender gap and writing about women. They have several events, and they asked me to create to help for the creation of a list of women who are underrepresented, but are human rights activists, feminists, notable feminists. Mm-hmm. So the list is ready and you can make use of it. I can link to it, but also ask from Austria about it.
We are in contact, I have you on Facebook.
You have almost all the people on Facebook.
Yeah, I mean, I try to follow everything. The subject is it's huge and it's very difficult to cover in this.
We simply say that we have a resource prepared that can be reused in your project as well.
Any other questions?
No. They are coming now. Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.